In this video, we're going to talk about creating a search strategy from your paper topic or your research question. A search strategy helps you to analyze the topic of your paper so that you can adjust your search to improve your search results. You don't want to just search, do you? You want to find. The search strategy helps you find the results you need. We're going to use a matrix to help us organize our analysis. If you're an English 1000 student, your instructor may have sent over a copy of this matrix as a handout so that you can edit that yourself. First, let's start with a topic. Let's say my research topic is about concussions in high school football. I'm interested in the long-term health effects of concussions sustained through high school football. What we're going to do is pull apart the concepts of my research topic. So I'm looking for the main topics of my research topic. One way to do this is to look for the nouns in my research topic. What are my nouns? There are three: football, concussions, and health effects. So yeah, those are the basic concepts of my research topic. I can use the rest of my research topic to help qualify those concepts. For instance, I'm not just interested in football, but specifically high school football. I'm not just interested in health effects, but specifically long-term health effects. So those are our concepts. Concept A, high school football. Concept B, concussions. Concept C, long-term health effects. When I'm doing a search, I want to include all three of these concepts. Right? I don't want just any old article that talks about concussions in high school football. I don't want any article that talks about long-term health effects of concussions. I want articles that talk about all three of my concepts, all three together. And that's why there are ands between each of my concept columns. I want concept A and concept B and concept C. I want articles on all three topics. Now, to make sure I really find what I need, I want to look at the words that I've used for each of these concepts. Are there different ways to phrase these concepts? If somebody has written an article and I want to find it, are these the words that they used? That's why we have more boxes in each column separated by or. It gives us different options for ways to phrase the concept. For instance, concussion is a pretty standard term, but I could also use the term head injury, right? It's different, but it's a similar concept. In medical science, they might use the term mild traumatic brain injury or MTBI. If I'm doing a search on concussion, it might not bring up those other terms. So I want to make sure I pulled that apart. As I come up with different synonyms, I add them to the different boxes below the concept separated by the or. Let's look at other ways our other concepts might be worded. For instance, high school football. Well, high school is sometimes called secondary school, right? Or we could even use adolescents or teenagers to discuss the kind of football that is played at that age, even if it's not for a high school. Long-term health effects. What are some ways to rephrase that? Health impact, health risk. Instead of long-term, we could consider the word chronic. There are different ways of phrasing that. Okay, let's take a look at the matrix. We can see that each concept has its own column with different synonyms separated by the ors. These don't have to be ands because I don't really need an article that uses all the different synonyms. I just want articles that use one of these. But I do want articles that use all three of the concepts. And that's why there are ands between the columns, because I need articles that cover all three. And or are two of what we call Boolean operators. The other Boolean operator is not. There might be reasons why you'd want to use not as part of your search, but it is more complicated. Does this make sense? In the next video, I'll break out a couple more search strategies to help you understand this a little bit better. And then in the video after that, I show you how to use the search strategy to search on the MU Libraries website. As always, if you have questions, you can use the chat widget on the MU Libraries website to get help from librarians at MU.